All right, that was Louie Go Home from The Great Jet Plane Happening, 1969, and that version was really no different from the original release, but it is off of The Great Jet Plane Happening 50th Anniversary Edition from the Sunshine Factory. Here on the show with me, I have Anna Stevens, who is a Fugees expert and knows a lot about the Fugees. Written three books on their career in the 60s and early to mid 70s. And I just wanted to say, you know, both those songs that we just played, You Better Run and Louie Go Home, were written by Max Fugee, otherwise known, especially at this time where it's starting to become noticed, is crediting his songwritings as R. California. He wrote both of those songs. Do you think the rest of the band, and as time went on with the R. California thing, do you think that they really minded?
Well, like, I don't know. It was family, and I mean, it was heavily saturated, but I think some albums were better than others, and it just really depended on how well the songs were, and and like the singles on this album, I don't know if you noticed, but they're really low. There's only two, and every other album has like four or five.
That's true, up until this point, and then even after. Yeah, definitely after. There's more than four or five, but
like they were like double A, like they were like the B side was just.
Yeah, I noticed you use that a lot in your book. You sometimes refer to a Fugee single that's really strong as a double A side. What does that mean?
It means like, well, on a single, there's an A side and a B side. And the A side is like the main hit, and the B side, they just kind of work in there. It's not as strong as the A side. So a double A single means, a double A side means that the B side is just as good as the A side.
And in a lot of cases, a hit too. Mm-hmm. So let's get into that. It's What's It Gonna Be, Him or Me? And then after that, we should talk about it a little bit before we play it. This was sort of like one of the first indications that Scooter was not happy with how things were going down as far as the producer. Yeah. You want to talk a little bit about the last two tracks on the original release, Psychodrama City and Foxtrot 242?
Well, they didn't have very many lyrics, especially.
No, because the Learjet song just goes, yeah. Come ride the Learjet, baby,
and
over
and
over.
And the other song, I think, even has Roger on it, and like, Scooter wasn't really happy with that.
That's right. Psychodrama City sounds like a jam. It doesn't even sound like it sounds like they're practicing or rehearsing. It doesn't even sound like a really thought out song. And then halfway through, this weird voice comes on and starts singing, who isn't Max, Scooter, Zach, or any of the Fugees.
Yeah. It's Roger McGuinn.
It's Roger McGuinn from the Byrds?
Yeah, the guy that was producing the album, but he did a lot more than that.
I know he played guitar, because I can tell when it's Roger McGuinn playing that Rickenbacker guitar, even though Max tried very hard to sound like him. I know that, I put two and two together, I'm not dumb, that he was producing, so he probably played guitar.
Yeah.
But you're saying he was singing now, too.
He came in and sang, yeah. So, like, the first album, in my book I talk about this, because, like, rock stars, yeah. So the first album had...
The first album where they left Brian?
Yeah. Chaz Chandler came in and produced the first album, so that was kind of like...
Scooter didn't have a problem with that?
Yeah, because he did it very professionally, and like they were just cut loose from Brian Ross.
Yeah, true.
But then...
And Columbia is a way better label.
Yeah. But then in this album, now he's playing on a bunch of songs, Roger McGuinn, he's producing it. This is their second run with
other producers
that are, like, friends
on Columbia. Oh, and that happened to be friends of Maxwell's.
Yeah, and then now he's singing, and then even the album after this, it's even crazier with Neil Young coming in, and like, just...
Yeah, because he's definitely on that album. I go home and listen to Broken Arrow. I hear Neil Young singing on two or three songs. He gets a writing credit on two or three songs. So he writes, he sings, he plays guitar. Was that just the last straw for Scooter?
Yeah.
So, okay, let's get into them now. That's What's It Gonna Be, Him or Me, the other big single from the album. Remember, there were only two, and then we're going to play Psychodrama City and the Learjet song. just for shits and giggles, because that was definitely a point of contention with some other band members, and we can discuss a little bit more why after that, and the segment that's going to come after this, we will finally get to the bonus tracks for this album, The Great Jet Plane Happening 1969 50th Anniversary Edition, right here on the Sunshine Factory Outlet Show.
But I know that it's not true. I've seen the way he looks at you, and I think you're gonna hang me up again.
Now have you got yourself a brand new baby? Don't tell me, baby, is it so? Share your loving with another man. And if you see things my way, could you let me know today? But if you decide it's him, I'll change my plans.
So now you've got yourself a brand new baby. Don't tell me, baby, if it's true.
I don't gate won't be here. I'm going to Florida for a half a year. Saigon City don't need none today. Me and my friends got on a plane. One of my friends got off again. To this day, I don't know why. Got on at all if they really didn't want to fly.
Saigon City don't need none today.
Me and my friend went over to my friend's house to see. Me and my friend on his TV. Before the night was over, I saw six murders, two riots, and a war. Not gonna watch my friend's TV no more, no.
Psychodrama City don't need none today.
Gonna ride in Egypt, baby. Gonna ride in Egypt, baby. Gonna ride in Egypt, baby.